Previously on Balls.
Wie aan u gaan het?
Ik ga baie goed aan die julle.
Nee, baie goed aan. Is die kop nog, nog seer?
Ja, die oog is niet seer. Die blauwigheid is wel bij je weg, maar hy is nog niet seer hoor, in die lijf ook.
Nee, ek het gepraat van die party na die wedstrijd.
Nee, ek kan nie so lekker daar nie.
So luister, round of applause, hande klap vir die vir die baby bokker. Yes, you guys were so motivated. You guys were really, I mean, I think what epitomized for me the whole performance and how when I saw, I think after one of the scrums wanneer die baby blacks teruggestoot het.
Ja,
en toe gee van Dijk vir daai ou a mournful. Yay.
I think, Van Dijk, he was up for the game. He wanted to scrum that guy.
But I mean, you see that kind of passion, and you just see it, and there was no, you just could see from the body language that there was not a hope in hell that the Baby Wocks were going to lose that game. You guys were fired up.
I think that was almost a turning point for us. I mean, yeah. After that, I think the guys, the All Black guys, knew that it was going to be a tough as well.
That's cool, and that's the right attitude to take. It doesn't matter who you're playing against. These guys have never lost a Junior World Championship final. It's only, the second game they've lost ever, right?
Yeah.
So kudos to you guys and kudos to your team, and particularly, Vian, because obviously, I mean, we never went through the whole tournament with one captain. Obviously, we've had Small Smith captaining and you guys, so there has been a bit of disruption, but really settled and a really, really strong bond in that side.
Thank you, Johan. I have to say, especially after the island game, we had to pull together as a team, and we really grew close to each other, and we became good friends. And that's why, even when I was injured, William stepped up and took the captaincy over, and he did an awesome job. And I think that was the great thing of this tournament for us as a team, is that everybody put in the hard work, and that's how we were successful.
So if made the role van Davi as coach, but specific not our yester game, it takes a brave man to make 11 changes to a side after a loss in the first game of a thing, but he did it, and you guys pulled yourselves right. So if made what's a role, hoe groot a role was die coach geweest in die hele opzet?
Ek moet
sê,
Davi en al die andere coaches, Zien en coach Brenda, was rarig voorraag geweest om soms te werken. We moeten zoveel kennis van die game, en hulle weet so baie goed, ons kan so baie by hulle leer. So it was really awesome, and I think the great thing that I will always remember about Coach Doggy and all the other coaches is that even after we lost against Ireland, they still kept on speaking positive to the guy. Even though we lost, they still believed that we could do it. And I think that was also we channeled that energy from them, and that's what also made us positive to keep on going.
Yeah, and it's not, I mean, as you say, your whole management staff, your Jonathan there, Johnny McQuinn as well, all the guys pitching in and obviously using their experience to help you guys.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, we had even the medical team and the physios and the whole management team was all there. And despite doing their jobs, it was nice people, hanging out with them, and it was nice spending time in Cape Town with them.
Vian, I don't know too much about you, but where did you go to school?
I was in HTS of the day in Worcester.
In Worcester?
So what now?
Yeah, now it's the beginning of the vakansie. And then, sal ek volgende maandag vir 'n bietjie terug gaan blou bulle toe en na 'n bietjie aan die een en terug gaan ek.
Have a lot of people who manages you now, because you guys are still youngsters, so are you already under management, and are people knocking their doors down to try and sign you, and what's happened since the big win?
Everybody just said congratulations after the win, and everybody just wants to pop in and come say hello, but luckily I've an agent who organized all my things, so he's in charge of my contract and everything, but I'm still at the Blue Bulls for the end of this year, so I'll still see where the road takes me.
Absolutely, and I was just thinking, watching you guys play, that in the next 4 years, I cannot see any side, and no matter how young England might be or what anyone might say, I cannot see any side other than the All Blacks. I think the All Blacks and the Springboks are going to dominate rugby in the next 4 years, because you start adding some of you guys into our setup. We get these guys like the young Huerson boy coming through, and then that brick shit house, Jan Serfontein.
Yeah.
Yay!
Yeah.
That oak.
Jan is the agent. That was great about this tournament is, even though, the people of South Africa saw guys playing for the team that they didn't even know of before. And, so this competition was a great way to getting your name up there into the country and people getting to know you as a player. So no, I think it's awesome for the future of South African rugby.
I'd be interested to know how Andre Pollard celebrated after the win, considering he's still at school. Do you have an Oros or something?
I'm not sure if he's 17 or 18. If he's 18, then he had a party, but I don't know if he's 17, what he did.
What a talent, eh?
Yeah.
Wow.
There's so much talent in that side, and that's the cool thing. What did you guys do after the game? How did you guys go and celebrate?
What did we do? After the game, we had like a function and meal for all the team. And then we just went to, after the function, we went to the hotel and then we had like a team meeting and just said thank you to everyone and just congratulated the team and the management. And then afterwards, we carried in the hotel, just there by the hotel bar, and with some of our parents and everybody. Oh, and then nice. After that, we were allowed to go out if you wanted.
Okay, with your parents.
Sorry?
With your parents. You're allowed to go out with your parents.
No. Your parents stayed at the hotel.
Okay.
Because the rumor is you all went for Happy Meals.
No, parents have to stay at home.
I would like to see you say that to his face.
Never.
Have you seen the size of this guy?
Yes. It's a never.
Luister, ons is baie trots op julle. Mooi so. And kan geniet die wereldkampioenskap. Enjoy that week you've got before you get back in France and the guys start putting you through your paces. And we look forward to seeing some of you guys getting through that system and into the senior sides soon.
Thank you very much. I appreciate all the support and thanks for all the South Africans. They were ready.
Is he still there?
Hello? No.
Hello?
Yeah, you're there, sorry.
Just last question, just out of interest, purely out of interest. What is Stephen Kitsoff's nickname in the team?
What is his nickname?
Yeah, because you all have nicknames for each other.
Yeah, there's a lot. Most of us just call him Kitter. Some other guys, some of the Paul Roos guys call him Chungu. I don't know all the nicknames. There's quite a lot.
You went to Paul Roos. What does that mean?
I don't know.
Chungu.
That's like they read like a storybook, and there was this Chungu guy was like a red hairy person or something.
A red hairy person.
Something like that. I didn't read the book.
All right, awesome. Lekker om saam met jou gesels weer. Alles van die beste, hoor. Sien jy daar by Loftus, een van die daar. Tot ziens, man.
Okay,
bye. There we go. That's Wiaan Liebenberg.
Now, don't you think that could be our future captain at the Rugby World Cup in the forthcoming years?
Well, we've got so many that are potentially coming through as well. That's the nice thing. That's why I'm so excited about our rugby.
Go all the way. I think he might. Brilliant! 2 p.m. to 6 p.m. Mondays to Fridays live on balls.co.za.